This is Susan Bradley for CSO Online. Today I'm going to talk about CVE-2020-1472. It's called the Net Logon Vulnerability. You might have heard about Zero Logon as well. It's an elevation of privilege vulnerability that exists when an attacker establishes a vulnerable Net Logon secure channel connection to a domain controller. Now, why is this a bad thing and why am I pulling it out and saying you need to take a second look at it? Because it's a very unusual patch that has a two-part to it. Now, normally on the second Tuesday of every month, we received updates to our supported Windows devices, we install them, and we go on with life. This one's a little different, and it needs a little more extra time for you to look at, because part of it gets patched now, and in February of next year, part of it gets changed later on. The patches are included in the August security updates, and they range from Server 2008 R2 all the way to Windows 10 and Server 2019. Now, if you have a domain controller, you may have seen out in the headlines to make sure that you have those updates on as soon as possible. The reason for that is the Cybersecurity Infrastructure Security Agency has already noted that there's proof of concept exploit code for this vulnerability out on the web, and they anticipate that attacks will begin to occur shortly, if they aren't already underway. The first phase of the patch released in August. Now, mind you, you can install September updates as well, and this will do the same thing because updates are cumulative. If you installed August or later updates to your machines, already it's enforcing secure RPC usage for machine accounts on Windows-based devices. It enforces secure RPC usage for trust accounts and enforces secure RPC usage for all Windows and non-Windows domain controllers. It includes a brand new group policy to allow non-compliant device accounts, those that use vulnerable net logon secure channel connections. So even when your domain controllers later on start enforcing this, if you have a older or legacy system that needs to be using the older system, you can go around it and you can adjust this. So at this time, you'll want to dump out your event logs into a process and then use PowerShell in order to review to make sure that you don't have these events identified in your systems. If you haven't patched on your domain controller, again, there is reports that exploits are beginning to seen out on GitHub and other places. And again, look for Zero Logon. Attackers could become domain administrators by subverting the net logon cryptography. If you've patched your domain controllers, you are safe from attack at this time. The remaining risk arises from third-party devices, legacy, or other devices that won't support this. Again, look through your event logs, make sure you're ready to go before the February date, and make sure you start the investigation now so you won't be blindsided by the impact of February's mandatory enforcement. Until next time, make sure you check out all the videos out on the YouTube channel for IDG Tech Talk. Thanks again. This is Susan Bradley for CSO Online. Stay safe, stay protected, stay secure.